Nothing interesting on this app anymore, man. Now I have to open Reddit. Wait, what if I integrated Reddit in Discord so I don't have to exit Discord anymore? So, how exactly are we gonna do that? Let's see. So, almost a year ago, Discord added the ability to create forum channels, which is essentially a place where users can create mini-chats, or as Discord calls them, threads. They can have a title, description, images, you can upvote and send messages in them. Do you see where I'm going? By combining Reddit's JSON feed and some Discord bot code, we could, theoretically, integrate a subreddit in Discord. Now, before you say that I'm milking Reddit again, Karen. You know what would be brave? Writing this project only with APIs. No wrappers or libraries, just Reddit and the JSON endpoint. Aww. Did I do that? No, of course not. Would I still hold the title of programmer if I didn't just copy existing code? Okay, jokes aside, I rarely create projects that depend on APIs since, you know. But I suppose this won't affect this project. Reddit, don't. Anyway, I found this library that interacts with Reddit's API. If you don't know, library equals code made by someone else. Everyone is just clicking out the video the second I show code. Anyway, yeah, I installed a library for the Discord bot as well. I also made a setup command which creates a forum channel.
Wow!
No way! Whoa.
Crazy!
And a fetch command which will gather the top weekly posts from a subreddit, go on each one and create a forum post accordingly. With some other info such as descriptions, upvotes, original poster, original URL. Also, look how clean the hyperlinks look. If you don't know, they got added a while back, removed, then re-added, and surprisingly, it makes the message look way better. And Discord had to ruin it with the lack of formatting support in the post preview. They were busy adding super reactions, I guess. Off topic, but I wanna add the fact that we still don't have an MP3 player integrated on Discord mobile. But, hear me out, we're being compensated with a better way to react on Discord. Okay, man. Also, what the hell? Why is this here? This was not here. I don't know how to feel about it. Either way, we now have images. And yes, they were a pain to deal with. Also, quick note, we can't artificially increase the upvotes in Discord, so we will have to display the Reddit upvotes inside the message. Now that that's done, I have to integrate a database to store the IDs of the posts that were already posted, so the bot doesn't create the same post next time it runs. I swear, man, this part is always the hardest and the most boring one, and I don't even know why. Probably the PTSD from making bots and Discord.js and rewriting them every time a new version releases. Who knows, it might be. Alright, I've integrated the database and encountered some interesting errors that I wanna show you. So if the script stumbles upon this post, which has one image, then the data should have preview, which also has images, which is an image. So since images is an array, you would expect it to be a list of images, not just one image. But no, apparently if there are more images, then the data is totally different. We got media metadata. It's not even an array, it's an object. Turns out that posts that have one image and posts that have multiple images are totally different in syntax. So what now? Well, the comment section. We have two ways that we can do this. We make the bot send every message from the post, which is essentially API spam, or we make the bot send an image with the comments from the post. And no, the image is not gonna be just a screenshot. No, no, no. It's gonna be purely written in Node Canvas, meaning everything in the image will be added using code. I've also got a lot of 429 errors, which meant that I was rate limited, but the header said otherwise. This bot is gonna be a pain to maintain. Alright, you know what? Maybe showing the comments in an image was not the best idea. I am not rewriting my code in Python to make it work. There is no way I'm doing that. I kinda knew that representing the comments section in an image wouldn't really work. But I did not think that the API wrapper would stop me. Anyway, yeah, turns out this library that interacts with Reddit is quite old and doesn't really handle rate limits well. But what does that mean? What's an API? What are you even talking about? It means that the bot won't be public since rate limits are way too harsh. Instead, you'll be able to run the bot for yourself. Thank God I didn't write the comment code myself and just use ChatGPT. time to type the iconic commands.
Today we're gonna be making a browser inside Discord.
How?
We'll be using Puppeteer and Discursive. Then I implemented Puppeteer into the script, which will represent me using Puppeteer.
What? Puppeteer old headless deprecation warning. What's that? What the hell? I ain't reading all that. Okay, this should help. Alright, let's get to reading. I wanted to make this bot as customizable as possible, so I made it so you can easily change the message, interval between posts, and more. So, I suppose it's done? No. Well, kind of, but I wanna replace MongoDB with some JSON to simplify the process of running the bot for yourself, since we just have to store a list of IDs. What will I use instead? Shut, don't say anything. It's simpler to run. So yeah, now it's finished. Comments being corded setup.
Don't
say anything about the name. Developers on their way to put cord in any Discord related project. Anyway, corded setup will create a forum channel in Discord, then each week the bot will fetch posts from Reddit and create Discord posts with them. You can force this to happen earlier by using corded force fetch, or you can customize the time interval. Oh yeah, you can also overwrite your data by using --force at the end of your setup command, in case you want to... Okay, I forgot what I made this for. Anyway, here's the recording of the bot in action. Overall fun project. If you want to use the bot, I'll probably have it hosted in my Discord server, which you can join with the link below. And if you want to use the bot for your server, check the GitHub link below. All that you have to do is create a Reddit account, copy some stuff, create a Reddit app, copy some stuff, paste it into the config file. Oh yeah, you also need to create a Discord bot. And you can tweak the customizable settings if you want. A big thanks to all the patrons and YouTube members for supporting the channel. Thanks for watching, and as always, see you in the next time. Thank you.